In this lecture, we'll derive the expression for the Gauss law when dielectric is placed between the plates of the capacitor. Now, let us take a situation where you have a capacitor and there is a charge, means they are connected to voltage supply. This has plus Q and this has minus Q. Always remember that these are free charges, means the charge which is on the plate of the capacitor, these are the free charges. And when we place a dielectric, there is induced charge on this plate, on the dielectric, on the two surfaces of the dielectric. If this is positive, you will have negative induced charge on this side, and this plate was negative, so you will have positive induced charge on this side. And let me just also take few minutes to explain how these charges come. We know that when a dielectric is placed in a magnetic field, the dipole moments of the polyatomic molecules get aligned. If this is the electric field, this is the electric field, and this is the dipole which is there in the dielectric, there is negative here and positive here. They get aligned along the electric field. So if you take couple of them, initially they are in the random orientation, so, and the electric field due to each dipole gets nullified and cancelled. But when they are placed in an electric field, what happens is that these dipoles, they align like this, and if I draw it like this, they are aligning like this, like this, yeah. So when you have electric field in this direction, the positive charge of the dipole will move in towards the electric field, and negative charge will come opposing the electric field, in the opposite direction to the electric field. So this will be the alignment of the dipoles in the dielectric in presence of electric field. So if you look inside the dielectric, the net charge would be zero because this is positive, negative, it is getting cancelled, and these are getting cancelled. But on the surface, there is this induced charge. We can call it bound charge also. It is that charge which I have shown here. And if the charge density of this charge is minus sigma p, and this is plus sigma p, the cross-section area being A, the total charge here on this side, the induced charge on this side will be plus sigma p A, and here it will be minus sigma p A. If L is the length of the dielectric, what is the dipole moment because of the induced charge on the surface, two surfaces of the dielectric? The dipole moment would be sigma p a into L. Charge times, it is minus q p, it is plus q p. I'll say minus q p and plus q p. Why I'm using p, I'll let you know in just few minutes. So this is the dipole moment. If we divide it by volume, total volume, volume is A times L, volume of the dielectric, we get sigma P, and this is called polarization vector. Polarization vector. That is why I have used this notation P here, and we can also write it as P. This is the polarization vector. Polarization vector is nothing but the dipole moment per unit volume. this is the polarization vector. So I will write this induced charge here as minus QP, and this is as plus QP. Now the electric field which is there between the plates in absence of any dielectric, we will write it as E0, and that was equal to Q by A will be sigma upon E0. Is the electric field in absence of dielectric. In presence of dielectric, the electric field reduces by factor K. E will be E0 upon K, where K is a constant for a given dielectric material. So the electric field inside the dielectric gets reduced. And why does it get reduced? If you look at the arrangement, this is the electric field, we call it E0. In absence of dielectric, this is plus plate and this is negative plate, negative. When dielectric is there, there is induced charge, and plus is on this side, minus on this side, plus QP, minus QP, which produces its own electric field. And this is opposing the electric field which would have been there had there been no dielectric. So the resultant field is equal to E0 minus the electric field due to these charges. What is the electric field due to these charges? It is QP upon A E0. So this is the expression which comes. If we write it as vector, it will be E is equal to E0 vector plus EP. We write this. EP is the electric field due to these induced charges is equal to sigma P upon A E0. QP upon A E0, which is sigma P upon E0, is the electric field due to the induced charges. So in vector form we write like this, and when we take the direction of EP, because it is opposing, EP is in this direction, E0 is in this direction, so that is why we are subtracting here. Now coming to the derivation, we write E is equal to E0 was Q upon A E0 is equal to minus QP upon A E0. And what is E? E is E0 upon K is Q upon A E0. 1 upon K is equal to Q upon A E0 minus QP upon A E0. So we get an expression for QP is equal to Q 1 minus 1 upon K. This is an important expression. This is the value of the induced charge. This is the value of the induced charge on the surface of the dielectric, and this is how it is related to the free charge. This is free charge. Now, if we use this expression in this Gauss law form, now if we again redraw it, and we will get a Gauss law for the dielectric. If we take this plate and this plate, this is plus here, and it is Q. Q is Q free charge. The charge on the plate is a free, we call it free charge. Please, I am repeating it because that is important to note. This is minus Q free. And the charge on the surface of the dielectric is minus QP here n plus qp here. Now take a Gaussian surface like this. If you take a surface like this, the electric field inside the plates, because these are conducting plates and the electric field inside the plates is zero, electric field here is zero. Here electric field is in this direction, and this surface area would be perpendicular. When you take E dot ds, the vector for the surface area is not along the area but perpendicular to area. The vector for the area is perpendicular to the area. So if E is, we are taking E in this direction, surface area in this direction, since it is 90 degree, E dot ds for this side is 0, this side is 0, here there is no electric field. So if we write surface integral E dot ds, it is equal to the electric field which is there, net electric field which is inside the capacitor, which is E0 upon K. E0 upon K times ds is equal to what is the charge enclosed by the Gaussian surface? It is Q minus QP. Q minus QP upon E0. So E dot ds is equal to Q minus QP upon E0. E dot ds is equal to, what is the value of QP? QP was, as we derived, is equal to Q 1 minus 1 upon K. You put the value of QP here and you will get, I'll use this side, this is Q minus QP, this is E dot ds is equal to, this is not required at the moment, leave it, we'll use this expression, Q 1 upon E0 is common, minus QP is Q plus Q upon K. Replace the value of QP using this expression, we put it here, we get this expression, and now E dot ds is equal to Q upon K E0. If you bring K here, it is K E dot ds is equal to Q upon E0. This is the Gauss law for the dielectric. This is the Gauss law, and the Q here is the free charge, is not the net charge, free charge. Q is the free charge which is on the plates. So this is the alternative form of Gauss law.